Y si tú la ves, baby, le vine a buscar lo que se llevó. Mi vida y felicidad, díganle que está frío el corazón. Desde que ella se marchó, necesito de su amor. Pa' que sale. Y si tú la ves, baby, le vine a buscar lo que se llevó.
This first clip here is just of me and my mate Robin. Out of the main city in Cozumel, basically. I came here the first time trying to spear some lionfish, and unfortunately didn't find any, but we found this ship just in sort of 8 to 10 meters of water, and it was really cool just to be able to go out and swim around, explore. I really enjoyed it. One of the really cool things about it was when I stuck my head down into the hold, and I was just amazed to see that it was full of these beautiful shiny fish just living in the dark, and it was quite a sight. As you can see, probably had about 30 meters viz on one of the days we went there, if not more, and the water's just lukewarm, 30 degrees, don't need a wetsuit. Yeah, it was awesome. This next little series of clips comes from when I did a trip out to the Blue Hole in Belize. This isn't actually from the Blue Hole, it's from another reef we dived, which is just absolutely incredible. Anyway, there was this group of Thai university students who'd come out in the boat as well, and they were scuba diving, so I just followed them from the surface. It was like 20, 30 meters viz, and I'd swim down to them and swim through the roof with them. Anyway, the reef was really cool because it had these giant grouper. I'm not sure exactly what species they were, but they'd just come and follow you around. There was also a bunch of big Caribbean reef sharks that I don't actually have in this clip, but yeah, it was really cool. The reef was sort of 18 to 20 meters to the sand, so you know it was a good distance to be diving up and down. I think the guys scuba diving quite enjoyed seeing me. I'd always surprise them because you're so silent when you're free diving.
Leyenda haciendo música. Saga White Black, La Industria Inc. Ya tú sabes.
Yeah, these big old grouper were really cool. Just they'd come in and check you out because the reef itself's in a marine reserve, so they'd become very tame.
Si el tiempo me ha borrado de ti, volví a caer, pequé de aprendiz, no pude controlarme, por eso te perdí.
So this clip here comes from when I went out another time with Robin. We were actually looking for the ship again, and there was quite a lot of current, and we stumbled across this reef that they'd made. Basically there was a big storm, and it got rid of all the coral from this area. And anyway, they'd put down a whole heap of concrete just to try and reseed the coral reef. But I found this one that was shaped like a tunnel, and I couldn't help myself. I'm not sure how Robin felt about me swimming through it, but it was in fairly shallow water, and I made sure I was going with the current. And yeah, it was a cool swim through. You can actually see there are a couple of little fish just chilling in there, and they got quite a fright. This pufferfish here is desperately trying to get away and ended up swimming the full length of the pipe with me. So these next couple of clips come from when I went to the city of Merida in the Yucatan Peninsula, and basically I just paid some kid on a motorbike to drive me around for half the day and explored these caves, or cenotes as they call them. So the Yucatan Peninsula is made of limestone, the geology of it. And anyway, they have all these underground rivers with this amazing clear water, and every now and again one of them just collapses and turns into these beautiful caves that just seem to go off into the depths and off into the shadows. Anyway, in this particular one I found this swim through, and there was actually a tour guide there, and he had no idea that it had existed, so he quite enjoyed seeing me pop up through the other side. Yeah. And then this last clip here just doesn't do the swim through justice at all. It's out in a place called Palancar Reef, which is basically what Cozumel's famous for in terms of diving. And I'd been out on the same snorkeling tour the day before, and the guide had gone through this really cool looking swim through, but it looked like a maze, and I didn't want to get lost, so I didn't do it. But when I went out with them the next day, I made sure I stuck behind him on this particular part of the reef and followed him through, and yeah, it was just awesome. It's quite funny though, because when I popped up the other side, he basically gave me shit about, why didn't you do it yesterday, basically calling me a pussy, and then yeah, I explained why and we had a good laugh.
I wanted to follow you. I didn't want to get lost.